All praise is due to Allah, and we ask Allah Ta'ala to raise the rank of our Prophet Muhammad and to protect his nation from that which he fears for them. Dear brothers in Islam, our khutbah for today is about our immense love for our beloved master and leader, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We will also talk about some of those who truly and sincerely loved him and to what extent they did. Al-Hafiz ibn al-Jawzi related through the route of Anas that he said, after the battle of Uhud, people became impatient and anxious, and some women in Medina began to scream when a rumor that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam had been killed spread. A lady from Al-Ansar arrived to the battlefield to find that her brother, father, husband and son had all been killed. People said to her, "These are your brother, father, husband, and son." Her astonishing reply was, "How about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam?" They said, "He is right in front of you." She walked over to the Prophet and grasped part of his clothing and said, "I favor you over my own father and mother. O Messenger of Allah, as long as you are safe, my grief shall diminish." She was confronted with the bodies of her brother, father, husband, and son lying still, and yet she was more concerned about the safety of the Prophet. And that is why she made her way over to the most beloved Prophet Muhammad, grabbing his clothes and saying, "I favor you over my own father and mother, O Messenger of Allah." It has also been related through the route of Anas, may Allah Ta'ala raise his rank, that a man asked the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, "When is the coming of the hour, the occurrence of the day of judgment?" The Prophet replied, "And what is it that you have prepared for it?" The man said, "Nothing other than the ordinary acts of obedience, except for an ultimate love that I have for Allah and his messenger." To that, the Prophet's response alayhi salatu wasalam was, "Then you shall be with whom you love," meaning the Prophet, "on the day of judgment." Abu Huraira, may Allah Ta'ala raise his rank, said to the Prophet, "O Messenger of Allah, when I see you, I feel elated and my eyes become filled with joy." And let us not forget our dear Master Bilal, the Muazzin of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When he was on his deathbed, his wife called out, "Wa hazana," which is an Arabic word, expressing her deep sorrow and grief. Bilal replied, "Do not be saddened, for tomorrow we shall meet with our loved ones, Muhammad and his eminent companions." In the end, we ask Allah Ta'ala to gather us with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam on the day of judgment, and to admit us to paradise without punishment. Ameen.